All right, let's throw it over to Joseph on this day that seems to be turning a little bit wet.
Yeah, we're going to transition to a soggy night and into tomorrow morning as well. We had a great start to the weekend, right? At least our Saturday began with some sunshine. Clouds increased as we went through the day, but it was a day to be outside, and it was a lovely weekend. I hope you enjoyed the start to it. We still have our Sunday, which is going to involve a little bit of rain. Here's a front, and then we have some cool unsettled air. You can kind of see the clouds patchy up there. That's going to be those unsettled showers as we head into tomorrow afternoon. But the first wave is going to be more steady, and that's because of this front that's going to help generate that rain as we head into tonight. Here's the Oregon coast, Cannon Beach up through Astoria. We do have some heavier rain there, represented with that yellow and orange color. And there's some very light showers there to the north. And it will, again, probably stick around for the next couple of hours until that front continues to transition and kind of stomp its way through the state, eventually making its way into the valley. Maybe some very light rain starting to pick up to the north in areas of Clark County and Cowlitz County there, maybe extending into areas of Battleground, but it's going to be very light. And even trying to pick up on a little bit of patchy moisture to the south, although unlikely that that is falling to the surface at this time. But when things become a little more saturated and we get some of the deeper moisture in, then we're really discussing some heavier rain. So rain totals tonight are pretty limited because this kind of started within the hour there along the Oregon coast. Not expecting much here until we get to maybe closer to midnight. But as I mentioned, we saw on the radar that there's some very patchy rain maybe just to the north of us. Front's kind of sweeping on through. By the time we get to 8:30, that front pretty much falls apart. But right behind it, we still have that northwest flow, that cool and settled air that I mentioned. And we'll probably still see some shower activity tomorrow. Now, rain totals will depend on if you see one of these downpours that we'll probably pick on up as we head into the afternoon. And it's cool enough aloft for even some snowfall for the mountains as we head into tomorrow night and into Monday. Another disturbance passes through late Tuesday into Wednesday. Then we dry up as we go into Thursday, but can't rule out maybe some more rain as we get close to next weekend as well as we get to Friday there. So it's going to be kind of busy. Rain totals as we go through the overnight hours into our Sunday. Here's a good representation of what we're probably seeing, upwards to about a quarter of an inch. And again, I think it really depends on if we get a downpour or two that passes on through some of the neighborhoods here, then we may have some higher rain totals. But I think it's safe to say that we'll probably be close to about 2/10 of an inch to a quarter of an inch for most locations. And then some isolated spots we'll see more than that, say Astoria through Vancouver. I don't think we're going to see as much down towards Eugene. I think the models are overplaying that just a bit. Okay, so for tomorrow, I do have plenty of shower activity in the forecast, but that doesn't mean it's going to rain all day. There's definitely going to be some breaks in the forecast as we go through the course of the day. But temperature is just having one hard of a time, a heck of a time to warm up tomorrow. I think it's just going to be pretty cool, about the mid-50s. We should be in the upper 60s, not even close, Wayne. We'll keep those temperatures in the 50s Monday and Tuesday as well. Pretty cool for the next few days.
Yeah, kind of dress rehearsal.
It really is, yeah.
All right. Early. Thanks, Joseph.